I sat down with Mayor Greg Fischer on this election day to talk about the expected record number of voters, how this year's early voting could change the future of how we vote in this state, and how to stay safe while we're still in the red. Take a listen.
Thanks for joining us this morning, Mayor Greg Fischer. A big Tuesday today in 2020. Have you voted?
Oh, yes. Yeah, actually, I'm wearing this today, but I voted a little while ago. Early voting has been fantastic. It's gotten record numbers of people out. People are saying, you know, why can't we do this all the time? So big hats tip to Secretary of State Adams and Governor Beshear for figuring out how to get people out here. It's been really beneficial. My hope is that we have record voter turnout. No matter which side you're on, it's just important that we cast our vote.
Do you think that the way that we hold this election this year is going to impact or change how further elections could be held in the future?
I hope so. If elected officials are listening to the citizens, I think citizens are saying we really appreciate all the flexibility to have different ways to vote, whether it's, you know, different ways to mail in the vote. Early voting in person has really been successful, and it takes a lot of stress off of having to vote on that one day. So more people can vote. They don't have to mess with their work schedules, with their family schedules. That's what you want in a democracy. And I think we're seeing some of that this cycle. So I hope it will continue, not just around the country, but specifically here in Kentucky.
Governor Andy Beshear's recommendation set in this week. We're seeing other countries around the world kind of going back, regressing, going back either into a lockdown or cutting back on their openings. Is that something that you see in our future if we're not going to get these numbers down?
You're seeing that in places where the healthcare systems are being overrun by the number of patients coming in. We do have an increase in hospitalized. Just for instance, today we have 264 people hospitalized. At the beginning of the month, it was 95. So you're starting to see this type of increase that we've going on. On ICU, intensive care unit, we have 58 in today versus 23 at the beginning of last month. So you're seeing this kind of scaling up that's taking place. So what the critical issue is right now, and the governor said this, is what we need is to, we just need to see people to comply.
FOP contract, it's a short-term contract, but what are your opinions about it?
Well, so we've got a short-term contract. That's what this one is right now. And then the longer-term contract is where we're going to put a lot more emphasis on the reform. This contract is meant to stabilize the police force. We're losing way too many of our police officers to surrounding jurisdictions that are just frankly paying a lot more for the police officers than what we are, especially the younger police officers. So that needs to be corrected. We've got a meeting scheduled in January to start on the next contract already that's supposed to go into effect July 1st of next year. FOP has said, yes, they're interested and working on ways to make the police department more accountable and responsive and enter those type of reform.